was a very late night in the state versus George Zimmerman court, lasting until 10 last night, with some nasty exchange setting the tone for things this morning.
Hours were spent arguing about witnesses and evidence, leading to many snippy exchanges with Judge Deborah Nelson, like this one about messages on Trayvon Martin's cell phone.
It's our fault. It's our fault. To deny Mr. Zimmerman the right to present this information violates both the Florida and the United States Constitution. Thank you.
The judge ended up walking out of the courtroom just after 10 o'clock last night, refusing to make any rulings. Now this morning, everyone is expected to be short on sleep and maybe patience as court begins at 9 o'clock. WESH 2 Stuart Moore is live at the Seminole County Courthouse. So Stuart, what does the late night from last night mean for this morning?
That means that the jury will not be brought into this courtroom this morning until some of these rulings have been made by the judge. We're talking about the animation that the defense wants to use, showing Trayvon Martin actually punching George Zimmerman. We're also talking about whether or not testimony from one of the defense's witnesses will be allowed because he possibly violated sequestration rules. The state and defense argued until 10 p.m. Tuesday night about whether an animation using George Zimmerman and witness accounts could be allowed into testimony, and finished the night by arguing if Trayvon Martin's text and Facebook message history should be part of evidence.
I don't know what else we could have conceivably have done under the circumstances to further this authentication issue under the circumstances that the state is solely responsible for.
The defense argues these two items are important to prove George Zimmerman's innocence. The judge did not make a ruling on that or if testimony given by Zimmerman's friend and supporter John Donnelly will be stricken from the record because he possibly violated sequestration orders when he was seen here inside the courtroom during other parts of testimony.
The most extreme sanction a judge can impose is to strike a witness's testimony or preclude a jury from considering a witness's testimony, and it would violate George Zimmerman's due process rights because he really had no part in this. So I think it's very unlikely they'll actually strike or remove all of his testimony.
The night ended with attorneys still arguing and Judge Nelson walking out.
It's 10 o'clock at night. We started this morning. We've had full days every day. Weekends, depositions at night.
And back here live, of course, Don West still arguing as the judge walked out. They were supposed to start proceedings at 8 o'clock this morning to continue taking up these issues. They have since pushed that back to 9 because of the late night, and all this will be handled before the jury is brought in. One thing to note, Mark O'Meara did say yesterday that they were probably calling their last witness before beginning to rest their case. So we could be hearing, once this is all concluded, the defense actually get up there and rest before they go into the next phase of the trial. Reporting live for the Seminole County Courthouse, Stuart Moore, WESH 2 News.